Hey, what's up, YouTube? This is the Alchemic. Coming at you today with another part of our free-to-play. Before we jump into the Hearthstone portion of this video, I actually wanted to go through a couple of decks that we have the potential to build on this account, and these are definitely the decks I do recommend playing if you have the ability to play only a single deck. So, first of all, this is a zoo deck list that I've been playing. These deck lists are from my normal account. So this is the zoo deck list that I've been playing. It looks really good. It's very solid. It will require two adventure cards, which is Dark Peddler and Imp Gang Boss, but those are relatively cheap. And then the rest of these are actually not very costly. Gormokhti Impaler is the only legendary in the deck. Everything else is more or less commons and rares, so it shouldn't be that hard to build. The next strongest deck is the Midrange Shaman, I believe. It does have Tunnel Trog, which is an adventure card, and quite a number of sort of epics and rares and stuff, but it is a very strong deck, and you do have quite a number of power cards like Flame Reef Faceless in this list to make it stronger. And yeah, this deck is overall very solid. I like it. And then we have Grim Patron Warrior. Does require getting Grim Patron. I believe that's the only adventure card, and Sir Finley Murgleton. Everything else is overall very solid. It's a very good deck against aggressive decks. One legendary once again. In fact, I believe the Midrange Shaman actually does cost more than this deck. But it is Patron is also a very good deck to play, and I do suggest playing this as well. And the last deck we have is Aggressive Shaman, the more face-oriented one, where you're playing two Doomhammers and two Ethereal Sentinels. But otherwise, you know, you also have Murgleton as well as Tunnel Trog. So these are they're relatively low adventure cost adventure cards in this deck, which makes it a very good time to start free to playing now. So these are the decks that I do recommend playing. And so these are the ones that I definitely I'm leaning towards the Zoo Warlock, because just Zoo has been popular the whole time, and like since pretty much the beginning of Hearthstone, and Zoo is a very solid deck. So I believe Zoo will actually be the deck that I'm leaning towards, though we'll see, because today we are actually going to be starting we're gonna get crack some more packs open. So there we go. Alright, back at the Hearthstone portion of this video. So we have one more game to win in order to complete a ton of quests and be able to basically finish, get those packs. We're going to get more quests along the way. So it should be a little bit more interactive now since we've gone through the grinding portions. And I can go ahead and show you all the priest cards after we defeat this person. So here we go with the same mage I played in episode 6. Ooh, Paladin. Okay, this looks like an unlikely matchup, just based on this guy. He has a card back and he has an alternate hero, so we're not very favored, but we're gonna try anyway. Alright. I'm not gonna coin one drop. Or two drop. Oh boy. I think we're against an aggressive paladin, which is not good. And we do need to play in standard mode, so that's kind of what makes this a bit difficult. This game's not worth playing. I usually wouldn't concede, but the thing is, if I'm playing against a player that has such a strong deck, I'm not gonna even really try, because it's not really worth playing against a real deck with my basic cards. So I do suggest doing that if you run into players like that, and just requeuing, because it's not worth just keeping on trying to win, because honestly, from my experience, just knowing that. And the fact that he has golden cards is also a suggestion. Most basic players, or you know, free-to-play players, I will get rid of all the golden cards, aside from basics. So this one looks like a winnable matchup, because he doesn't have a real card back. So
it is on.
This looks good. Turn one Argent Squire is very I like it a lot. It's very good. Let's see if we can curve out. Oh, that's not bad. So this one looks like a more winnable matchup than that previous one. The previous one was playing a Divine Favor aggressive paladin.
The light protects me.
People who play Mirror Image on turn 1 are generally not very good, so...
Fight. Are you my master? We must cleanse the Sunwell. Fight.
So C'Thun stuff. I just want to know how this guy built the deck. Because most, a lot of people just play the Beckon Revival and then play a ton of basic cards. So maybe he has more things to buff C'Thun, you know. Arcane Explosion. Arcane Missile. That's actually not bad for him. Wow, those missiles never miss. Arcane hit holes. They don't miss. That was a pretty insane arcane missiles. None to face is quite surprising. Another arcane missiles. Alright, though that one hit a little bit of face damage. Which I like. I like the face damage. Because face damage doesn't really matter in these in this kind of matchup. We're being pro. I don't remember why this card's in my deck. It's not really that good, actually. Now that I think about it again. But yeah. Someone told me this thing can extend. The telescope on the LOE map can extend, that's what it said. Oh, that's pretty good. Can it extend? Oh, that's what it means. That's cool. I like it. Oh, mark the Doom cards. That's good. Good for him. Hit that. Or hit that with this. Just to make nothing hittable with his fire blast hero power. And then if he has flame strike, it's alright. But then at least it burns the flame strike, so.
The master hungers.
That's actually good because now I can trade this in. So.
For the eye.
Alright. We're on our way to getting our packs. Hooray. This accounts, hooray. This is kind of people who just slap together random cards. Don't really understand the strategy. And that's what gives more experienced players who are running the free-to-play accounts a little bit more advantage. Alright. Let's crack our packs open. I'm actually not going to open these at the end of the thing, because I want to see what cards we get. There's five Old Gods packs. Alright. We can also buy two more packs with our gold. So I think we're gonna pick up some classic packs. Alright, 7 packs for this video. Exciting. Buy 2 of these. Which one doesn't matter? I open the old gods one first. That's pretty good. This is good for our zoo warlock if we want to play it. Exciting. This is good. Oh, another one. That's good. That's really good. I like it. Zoo warlock. More zoo cards. Card. That's a good thing card. It's alright. Last old god pack. Let's get something good. Two rares is great. This is actually good for Patron Warrior. I like it. And this is Aggro Paladin. So, we got a little bit of synergy. Let's see if we can pick that up with the Zoo Warlock more stuff. Because I do like Zoo Warlock. Two rares is actually a good pack. I like it. And the last pack. Wow, that is a pack, man. Wow, that is insane. How much dust is that? This is a rare is 100. It's 400. This is no. This is so we get 100 dust, 120, 220, 320, 325. Wow, that tops, I think, most of our packs except that legendary pool. Wow, that is pretty insane. All right, let me just see how much dust we actually have. So, let's go through all of these cards. That's pretty good. I like it. I'm gonna actually see how much stuff we can craft according to my deck list. Alright, so I'm gonna go back on the web browser. Let's see, I'm gonna use the calculator. Where's Okay. Alright, so we have two rares on this. I'm not sure how much the deck costs, so go. Oops. Okay, so the Zoo Warlock deck that I want to play costs 3,200 dust. About 3,200. So let's build our Warlock deck now. But just with the cards that we have already. So this is good. Part of the deck. This is all really good. I like it. Do we have any other cards? I'm not actually quite sure we have any other cards. Wait, did I disenchant everything? Oh no, I didn't. So maybe we'll just build the core of the deck. We'll get rid of some stuff that we know we're not going to use. And also, a good thing to sort of learn is how to find replacements for cards that you want to build. So I think we can start working on sort of just the core of the deck. First, let me disenchant this stuff. So I think we're going to start building the deck. And the hardest part is figuring out what is the most important thing. So first I'm actually going to get rid of all the stuff I know I'm not going to use. Since we're going to focus on Warlock in this, and I really like Zoo as a Warlock deck. because I feel like Control Warlock is very expensive and not very not something I really favor too much. I think that card is keepable. These are all quite keepable. I'm gonna get rid of stuff, and like I said, I know I'm not gonna use, like Shatter. I thought it was decent at first, but it's a little really situational once you play in an actual deck. So, oh, I'm not gonna play the secret, actually. Probably not gonna play this. It's not played in enough good decks that I'm not willing to keep that card. I don't think I'm gonna play Light Well. And that's on this account. So I'm probably not gonna play C'Thun Priest if I'm playing. If I'm playing a Zoo Warlock, I should focus on the Zoo Warlock. Yeah. No, I'm sorry. I would keep you, but the problem is there are so many cards in this that we actually need, so. And maybe we'll go back and fix some things afterwards. Like delete some of those decks since we're gonna focus on this Warlock. And there's enough for some Sea Giants. I don't like this card. It's a little too expensive for me. Get rid of some of these. I'm effectively getting rid of like mostly every card that I have. Because focusing is kind of one of the key things of managing a free-to-play account is commitment to a certain deck and then learning how to just basically master it. And though I think Zoo Warlock is a good one to work on because it is kind of a skill deck. It takes a little bit of skill to understand and mess around with, but there are decks that do take more skill for sure, but I think Zoo Warlock is a good one. We're gonna keep some of the Patron Warrior cards like this, and I got rid of the Golden Inner Rage, but I do not think it's necessary. What?
Life Fox.
Ew.
Yes, I told you before.
No, I'm still recording. I'm gonna stretch after this break. So originally, I think the decklist was playing some shield bearers just to protect your things. But, I don't know. Shield Bear is not very strong anymore, sadly. Unlike it was earlier. So we're getting rid of everything, effectively. This card, if we're gonna build a deck that's better, we're gonna not use that. Some other cards are definitely keepable. Like, Pyromancer's actually played in some Grim Patron Warrior lists. An Acolyte of Pain is really good in Warrior, in general. So we're not going to spend all this dust and craft one legendary, because that's just not very smart. This card's just not very good enough. Not good enough for a little bit of competitive play. And we're trying to take this and get as high as we can. Don't think I'm going to be playing this card, actually. I can keep that. Cool, these two are actually decent, and I might play them. This is played in some warrior lists. I don't think... I might not use it, but... Definitely not going to use this card. Da 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 da. This card's not gonna use it either. Not gonna use this. Way too conditional. Though I like the design, it's a little too conditional. Get some of these. Alright, so now, I can get rid of this. Okay, maybe is there one more common? I would like to get rid of one more common. Soul of the Force, alright. Perfect. So now, this is our zoo. We're gonna craft all of the necessities for our zoo warlock. Basically the core cards, not like the things that are like fun to have. So with this much dust, I think part of the core is a lot of the one drops, which is what makes the deck so strong. So actually no, I'm not gonna start. I'm gonna start with Flaming. A lot of people who learn how to play Zoo Warlock is sort of like the Flame Imp. The turn one Flame Imp, they're like, wow, turn one Flame Imp, oh, that's yeah, really good. So, turn one Flame Imp. Let's see, more core cards. Just basically stuff that's sort of on the classic set that's used in this Zoo Warlock. We got most of them already. I'm gonna craft some 2-drops now, actually. I think most of the 1-drops we got that I'm actually gonna be using. Oh wait, hold on, we need to make one more Abusive Surgeon. So we'll do that. And then, now let's move on to some 2-drops. So, Knife Juggler is one of the most infamous, in fact. And definitely really good. Synergy with a lot of stuff. Dire Pack Alpha, indeed. Maybe we craft one of them right now, actually. Only one is really is important in this list for right now. And we'll find some other substitutes later. So... We still have a ton of dust left, so I'm gonna craft some of the other core cards. Like Power Overwhelming. Basically makes your minions trade in super, super fairly. Absolutely. Some of these. Forbidden Ritual. I just call it Forbidden Tentacles. And then the card is, of course, synergizes with, in the new set, is a Darkshire Council. Originally, I thought this card was really bad, but, you know. Opinions change. We'll also go to 4-drops back into neutral. And one of the core cards in this deck is also Defender of Argus, which is kind of what makes the deck very strong as well. To wrap it up, I think... Let's see. Okay, let me actually put it together first. Let's see. Let's see what we get. Okay, I think that's it, right? We'll play Dark Iron Dwarf because this is actually one of the stronger cards that was actually originally used in a lot of zoo decks. So we have an... let me see, wait, do I have any more rares? Whoops, lol. Okay, so let's get out of this. Let's see, do I have any more rares that I really think I can disenchant? How can I Soul Priest? Vaporize is not playable. Alright, and then Flare is not playable, I don't think. These are, this is actually worse. Okay. So, one more card I actually want to make it a priority to craft is on the expensive side. The second most expensive card in the deck is Sea Giant. No, Sea Giant. It's kind of one of the powerhouse cards in the deck that had made a return after the demon versions of Zoo started leaving, or left the meta. So part of that, and then we'll go back to here. Actually, I forgot to add this in. And then our last couple hundred dust are gonna be used on some Doom Guards. Alright. And with that, we've got most of our Zoo Warlock decklist. The last cards we do need, however, aside, so this is the original list. This is most of what the original list had. We're missing one of these. The cards we're missing now, I believe, are Dark Peddler, which is an adventure card we'll work towards. The second Darwolf Alpha. Imp Gang Boss, which is another adventure card. Gormok the Impaler, which is the legendary, the most expensive card of the set. So, after this, I believe we are going to... So, let me see, hold on, how much dust do we need left? Oh, that's weird, okay. Yeah, okay, this was not working for a second. So, we're missing... This is 40 dust and 16. So, 1,640 dust left. Or pulling this and Gormok, basically. Alright, I like it. We are very much on our way. Alright, so let's discuss finding a little bit of substitutes to play. So, whenever you don't have a full deck like this, if you guys compare it to the other list that I had earlier... you will probably not have every single card that you want in the deck, because it's quite difficult to build the entire thing out of such little cards and without paying money. So I feel like Mortal Coil is actually a decent card to play. I'll play one of it right now. It's a decent card to play right now because you can deal that, you can use that extra one damage. It'll be very helpful. In addition, more chargers are also happy to have, but not that one. I don't think we can put acidic swamp oozes actually, one ooze actually, just to tech against some weapon decks that we might struggle with. So something that would summon like a Light's Justice or something with a big weapon. Biofin Tidehunter was in the original Azu list that I was taking a look at, using as reference to create my own. So let's try and stick to the curve of this, of the original Zoo. So our last two cards... Okay, This deck does just generally curve high up at the top of the curve. But... I'm not quite sure what cards I'm supposed to be playing. Yeah, losing not having Imp Gang Boss is pretty huge for this deck, which kind of sucks. But we'll have to grind to get that card. Just a sticky 3-drop minion, so maybe a 3-drop. 3-drop. Shattered Sun Cleric. Alright, so this is our deck, and we need 1640 dust to finish it. Alright, so in the next episode, we will be taking this deck for a little test run and see how we can do on the ladder. Hopefully this season we'll be able to make rank 20, at least, and then we'll work up from there once we can start working on the other cards. But Zoo Warlock is going to be this account's main deck. Actually, I forgot to mention, we still already have a lot of dust from this legendary, and I'm not sure, do we have any other epics? That's the only epic we got. Okay, do we have any rares? These are all needed. I already crafted. Okay, so we have 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, and then, okay, 180. So we have 580 right now. And of course, we got more packs coming out. So, yeah, this is very exciting. I'm really happy to start this free-to-play and teach you guys sort of how to operate with a... without really spending any money, because that's what I was originally doing. Except I basically was playing with Combo Druid, which was the really good deck at the time. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. In the next episode, we will test out our Zoo Warlock on ladder, on the actual rank system, and see how we're able to do once we can hit that rank 20 threshold, hopefully. we can make it on. And I hope you guys are excited as I am. Thank you for watching. And like, comment, subscribe. I'll see you in the next episode.